All right, I'm gonna keep this hand. It's not stellar, but I have lands and I have one of my best cards in the matchup. Funny, I last minute was deciding between the fourth copy of Thassa and the first copy of Domestication. Ended up going with Thassa, but I would really love to change one of these two Thassas into Domestication here. Oh, perfect. Makes the hand a lot better. Okay, so seems like I'm just going to tap down the Fire Drinker Satyr. I can even attack for two if I do that. Another play you can make with Rapid Hybridization is to cast it on your own Thassa. Of course, that only works if Thassa is active, but indestructible, so you just get a three, a free 3/3 out of it. I don't want to trade off the Tidebinder Mage, which means I might as well attack with it. And then I'm just gonna go judge a familiar with Thassa. And then this turn is kind of gonna be his chance to get in a big hit. Probably one of the best things he could do would be Madcap skills on Fire Drinker Satyr. And then I have no good blocks. Blocking here for sure. That's funny. Bottom. Perfect. It's actually worth it for me to just attack with Thassa because I could leave it to block, but that's fairly unreliable. If he just kills Tidebinder Mage. Plus, I'm kind of winning this race, so might as well go for it. Jace should virtually always plus one in this matchup, unless it's like an extreme emergency. And you're digging for something to survive. Okay, fair enough. So this is going to be the tough game where I'm on the draw. I'm going to stick with the same sideboarding plan. Permission's definitely too slow. Only other card I'm considering is Domestication, but I like everything that I have in a little bit better. if I hit four mana and have one of these cards, then that's exactly what I want. And I just want to maximize my chances of making sure that A, I hit that four mana, B, that I'm not completely dead by the time I do. So therefore, just keeping all my cheap proactive plays.